as I see it on YouTube. So you're a star on YouTube. We can't see you, but we hear you going, yeah! And like, sort of every third bar. So, yeah. So like, if you go through a drive-thru and they say, would you like to supersize that? You go, yeah! I have a set list, is that one right?
Can I have it?
We weren't gonna have a set list, I wasn't gonna do one. This phone, the Jeff's phone I had last time. I was gonna have it so that you would have a list of like 50 songs and then you could call that. Not kidding. And I would pick it up and then you could see, I would take a request. I was gonna
do it. Stop moving it!
They couldn't do it. There's no phone line to do it. But some other time, next time.
I love you!
It's only 2010. You can't just put a phone in anywhere. If there's some specific song you want to hear, just like.
Original fire!
Hold the strike!
Original fire!
Hey, Rob Simon. Wow, those are good choices. You don't care what I play, just make sure I play that. Alcoholic song is an alcoholic song. It's not a 12-step song. It's just a guy that's decided maybe it's better if he doesn't drink. There's no steps. There's hope and promise, faith. Some forget to rise. Well, I'm lonely and I'm thirsty, but it's better I stay dry. Never boil down to drinks away from crying. Still round the true bless. A wave full of time to pass. And I'll thank you for the offer, but you know I must decline. Never fall in to drinks away from crying. There used to be a time when I could hold my head up high. Life laid out before me. Midnight turns to day. When I'm lonely and I'm thirsty, but I cannot tell a lie. Never more than two drinks away from crying. Thank you.
Play it again.
And thanks for coming to this show. This is a lot of fun for me. Let's meet the Seasons group and we'll meet at the particular sort of semi-stage left. Done.
Screen and then read the screen.
So that's kind of a sweatery thing.
Mary Cobain.
Right?
Mary Cobain.
Although I'm looking around, I don't see any sweaters except me. I'll fit in, I got a sweater. No, I don't fit in. It's going on. Someone said highway to hell. Someone said I have a horse or I have horses. I don't know that one. I can make it up. Yes, I do. Call them Trudy. That's how it's a work in progress.
Yeah.
I brought that guitar just for that song. So now the guitar doesn't have to feel bad. Now the guitar can be happy that it's... I love it. I can only play it for that song, but I love it. Nobody on the phone. It was gonna be you. It was like, they made like a Bluetooth connection for this phone now, but it's like such a new thing that they made it, but it doesn't work. But they made, like, that's the first step. You make it, it doesn't work, and then you fix it. But in the process, see, I didn't know what Bluetooth was. I thought it was just those little Spock things that you put on your ear and then you talk. And it came to me that they should give it to crazy people who talk on the street corner who are just talking. That's the quick fix. It's not medication. Give them a Bluetooth and problem solved. They're not going to stand out and cry. They're not going to feel bad. Problem solved. Dennis Hamm out now. Ladies and gentlemen, Dennis Hamm on the piano. You don't know yet, but in a second you'll be like, oh my God. Now this is next song actually was written to be performed this way. And it was never done because, like, once I started recording it, it seemed a little weird. Soundgarden had just ended. It was the first solo thing I did. I was like, okay, I'm just singing a song to a piano. So we didn't really do it that way. But this is the way that it was supposed to be done.
Oh! called.
Angel on Fire?
I heard that one, Angel on Fire, recently. I know they do. They're nice people. And I didn't bring the guitar that plays it. There's only one guitar that plays that song. All other guitars actually refuse to play it. But there's one that will do it. And I left it home. It needs me. He can't play it without me. And I fucked up. So I'm sorry. I apologize. Next time. This one is... This was a song that I wrote specifically for a movie, which was a modern adaptation of a Charles Dickens classic. And I'm not sure that's a good idea ever, to do a modern adaptation of a Charles Dickens classic. You can make a new one that still seems old, but this one was supposed to seem new, and it had some good things about it. But anyway, this is called Sunshower.
Of a God.
Every time someone calls one out, it reminds me of something. Mind Riot was actually the first song that I ever stood up in front of an audience and played where I was just singing and playing the guitar.
Again.
And the reason why, there's a reason and you need to know it, because this is part of why I don't just drop these songs when you ask. That song was written where every single string on the guitar is tuned to E. And guitars don't like that. That's why I did it alone, because if we all did it together, it sounded horrible. But if I just did it alone, it was a little out of tune, it didn't really matter. It was it's experimental. It's an experimentation, which is a good thing.
I love you, Chris.
Thank you. But I was thinking, no, really, I was just thinking about, I haven't played that song in probably 15 years, so that's a good. This next song, someone held up a sign for it a minute ago. This I wrote from my beautiful wife over sitting over here. Yeah, look at her. She's trying to hide. And I tell this story, but I played this for her at our wedding. I wrote it for them, and it's called Finally Forever, and here it is. Why are you going up the stairs? Why are you hiding?
Get her up
I'm
there.
Playing it for you, really.
I will be there for you, I know, but you'll always
it's finally forever. Some friends of his reached out to me and said, why don't you call Rory, because he's an enormous fan and he loves you and he's afraid to reach out to you, but we're going to on his behalf, because he had cancer in the stem of his brain, and his daughter, who I think was 8 years old, died of the same thing. And so I did something that I'd never done before. He wrote a beautiful, super touching poem from the perspective of his daughter, and he just, after we'd become friends, he just texted it to me one day because he wanted me to read it, and I put it to music, And then I recorded it, and it was actually available to download, and some of the proceeds went to help his cause. But he passed away right after the last show that I played here at the Hotel Cafe. And so this is his song. This is Rory's song. I just want to play it now.
No news was Dennis! Dennis! Go!
have some noise.
This is his wife, too.
Let's take Tony. This, I just learned this. I can't really play it, but I was messing around with it in our house. You know how people sing in the shower? I actually rehearse in the shower. I go in there with a guitar and I play. And so my kids come up and they look at me because it's a weird thing, and they I don't know, they just look at me funny, curiously. It doesn't matter what I tell them, they just think it's weird. But anyway, I started playing these notes, and my daughter Toni came up, and she's seen me play songs tons of times, and I started playing these notes, and she looked at me, and she actually kind of almost blushed, and it was like this magic moment, and she said, "How do you make that sound? I don't know how you make that sound." And she was just really into it. And this is the song, and so I'm just going to do it.